Peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Oh, welcome to the 17th Sunday after the Pentecost. And in Pentecost, as we journey through this season, we still have 10 Sundays to go in Pentecost. But in Pentecost, our heart, the church's heart, is focused on the Lord's working in the life of the church. And as Christians, there's a lot of implications as followers of Jesus Christ. We struggle with doubt. And as we look around our world, we see a lot of afflictions, a lot of pain, a lot of illnesses, and a lot of suffering. But the scriptures always remind us that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character. And we have to hold on to that, because we have the greatest example of character in Jesus Christ. He was ridiculed. He was spit on. And he was killed. But he did the will of God the Father. And through those afflictions, he rose again from the dead for the forgiveness of all our sins. We see sin running rampant today. Unlike, seems like any other times in history, we're going through some rough times right now. Discord, dysfunction, fighting, wars, natural disasters. But we got to stay faithful. Our scriptures today, no matter what we're going through, we have to stay faithful. And I was reading this, it was just a great phrase last night. It says, don't let our inability be compared to God's ability. I thought that was so profound. Don't let our inability be compared to God's ability. If you stay faithful, all things are possible to those who believe. We are believers. Stay faithful. And we have a God that's able to do all things. Amen. As we gather, in today's gospel, the father of a possessed boy says, if you can do anything, as if God in the flesh, as God in the flesh, Jesus can do anything. He can do anything he wants to. His concern is never an if, but an always. His concern is never if, it's always. When our troubles increase, their resolution awaits not God's intention, but our waffling faith in his concern. Few of us have the resolve and the bravado of Isaiah in the Old Testament reading. Seldom do we recognize how we use our tongues for both good and for evil. Today's scripture encourages us to turn from relying on ourselves to putting our faith-borne trust in him alone. Amen.
The Lord is blessed.
The 12 were in trouble in today's gospel. They couldn't exorcise the evil spirit in a man's son. The boy's father was helpless too. Jesus had no problem with the task. He exhorted the disciples to turn to him, saying, "This kind cannot be driven out by anything but prayer." Our tongues are not employed for prayer that often. However, the epistle notes that, like the rudder of a ship, our tongues are powerful. Only Isaiah, prefiguring our Lord's attitude, has the right outlook. Relying on our Heavenly Father, he is ready for a fight. Our Lord can take care of our problems. We must rely on his strength and his caring. The introvert has good encouragement. Be strong and let your heart take courage. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Please rise. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Fear the Lord, you his saints.
For those who fear him lack nothing.
Many are the afflictions of the righteous.
But the Lord delivers him out of them all.
Hallelujah. All things are possible.
For one who believes, hallelujah.
Join in our opening hymn, "Come, You Thankful People, Come." Thank you.
charge at last. In the fire the tares to cast, but the fruitful ears to store in his garner evermore.
Hear it, so Lord, quickly come to the final harvest home. Gather all your people in, free from sorrow, free from sin, there forever purified in your garner to abide. Come with all your angels, come, raise the glorious harvest home.
You may be seated. Let us confess our sins, and let us receive our absolution, which is a free gift from our resurrected Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
If you, O Lord, kept a record of sins, O Lord, who could stand?
But with you there is forgiveness, therefore you are feared.
Since we are gathered to have our faith strengthened by hearing God's word and by receiving our Lord's body and blood in the fellowship of this altar, but cannot come before God in our sinful condition, let us seek his infinite mercy and ask our Heavenly Father's forgiveness.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive the weakness of our faith and our many sins, and restore us to fellowship with you one another, now and forever.
In our holy baptism, our Heavenly Father declared us to be his children and united us to his Son, whose death and resurrection all our sins are forgiven. As a called and ordained servant of Christ, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Be strong and let your heart take courage, all you who wait for the Lord.
But I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God.
My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from my persecutors.
Make your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your steadfast love. Glory be to the Father. Be strong and let your heart take courage, all of you who wait for the Lord.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia. Hallelujah.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, as you go with us through each day, help us. Dear Lord, please help us by your strength. Help us to serve you in meeting people's needs. Help us in spreading the good news of the gospel. We ask all this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever.
Amen.
May the God of peace and joy fill you all with hope and love. Peace be with you.
And also with you.
Greet everyone with the wave of peace. So the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
In our ministry, today I'm going to read from Jesus Always. Jesus is always right on time. And today Jesus says, I can smooth out all the tangled up places, including those in your mind and those in your heart. He says, so come to me just as you are, with all your knotty problems and all your loose ends. Many of your difficulties are complicated by other people's perplexities. It can be hard to sort out how such of the mess is yours and how much of the mess is theirs. Be willing to take responsibility for your own mistakes and sin without feeling responsible for the sinful failures of others. I'm here to help you untangle your complex problems and find the best way to go forward. Christianity is all about transformation, a lifelong process. Some of the knots from your past are hard to untie, especially when they involve people who continue to hurt you. Beware of getting stuck in introspection or obsessing about how to fix things. Instead, keep turning to me, seeking my face and my will, Wait with me, trusting in my timing for unscrambling things and making your way clear. Be willing to live with unresolved problems, but don't let them be your focus. My presence is in the present of your portion. My presence is your boundless blessing. This is the word of Jesus Christ. Amen. Call to prayer.
Oh Lord, hear my prayer. Oh Lord, hear my prayer. When I call, answer me. Oh Lord, hear my prayer. Oh Lord, hear my prayer. Come.
Let us pray for ourselves. Let us pray for the church around the world. And let us pray for all people in their various conditions. Today's psalm is the response of a trusting person, confident that God has heard the prayer. Be present, Lord our God. Whatever wars rage and governments fail, where homelessness and disease are rampant, and where the poor are forgotten. Lord, guard, defend, and give wisdom to all who go into harm's way to do battle against foreign enemies and in the emergencies here at home. Use medical personnel and caring neighbors to bring about health and healing. Provide faith-filled leaders and followers to proclaim the gospel, to serve you with gifts that you have given them, and care for the needs of the people all around the world. We love the Lord because he has heard our voices. He has heard our pleas for mercies. Be with all who tend to flocks, who raise harvests, and distribute food so that many may be fed. Dear Lord, visit, relieve, and console those who are sick or in mourning. Lord, we pray for Faith Lutheran Church, Marcia, Zoe, Betty, and Desmond. We pray for Burrow Taylor, Narcy Leonard, Sonia and Rosa. Pray for Shaylin Larita, Lucia Adams, Ava Simone Angulo, and Kimberly Andrea Angulo, Deborah and Joseph and Lester. Pray for Freddie. And we pray for Kurt Bauer, Lord, and Christ Lutheran Church, as he continues his education and put on a great musical event at Christ Lutheran. Beautiful day yesterday. God bless you, Kurt, and all the leaders at Christ Community over there. We pray for Gwendolyn Bob and Tony Broaden and Sylvia. Pray for Ms. Carol Brown. Good to talk to you this week, Ms. Brown. Pray for your son, Aaron. We pray for Kim and Rodney, Ms. Shirley, Weldon Sr. We pray for Adrian Carrington and Timothy Wallace. Pray for our beloved Mimi Carmichael. Good to see you. We pray for Zelda Carter, Devin Carter. Pray for our beloved Cheryl Chandler and all the work she does and all the prayers that she leads for all of us, Lord. Pray for Albert Bob and Derek Chandler, June Chandler Enoch, London, Riley Chandler. Pray for Troy and Sabrina. Pray for Sharon Collins and Carol and Don and Sierra. Lord, we pray for Brother Dwayne Clifton and his prayer request for his friend Inez Hayes. Lord, be with them. Heal them. And Lord, let you know that you love them and cast all our burdens upon them, on the Lord. We pray for Odessa and Mike and Sandra. Pray for William. Pray for Aunt Dolores and her journeys, Lord, to her school back in Africa. We pray for Leslie. Pray for Claire DeCure. Pray for Grant and Terry Vermel. Pray for Dorothy, Lucille, May, and Mildred. And Lord, we pray for Deacon Reggie Fields and his lovely wife, Marilyn. Good to see you both here. God, we prayed and keep telling you, God answers our prayers. Just have to be patient. We pray for Jesse and Rolette and Kenneth and Oakland and Sacramento and Vallejo. Pray for Elena. Pray for my mom, Ruby, my wife, Sabrina, our son, Anthony. Pray for Udolpha. Pray for Barbara Getz. We'll pray for Patsy and Stephen, Leslie, and John. Pray for Bishop Cleophas and First Lady Stephanie. Pray for Elders Steadham and First Lady Valencia. We pray for Elaine and Lynn, and pray for Brother Sean. And we pray for the wrestlers, Lord, as we all have struggles. But we pray for Mikey. And we pray for the amped up wrestling, Lord, that they stay bonded together and that they put you first, and you will deliver all from their troubles. Pray for Simone and Stephanie and Donald Hillman and Christ Community Baptist Church here at Faith. We pray for Patty and Joey as they relocate, and pray for Joey and Gail and Lamont. Thank you both. Pray for Keishelle, Lamont Sr. Pray for Keish. Pray for Brother Taylor, Zenora and Tishana, Carl and Eula May, Kurt, Randy and Rayner, and pray for Douglas. Lord, we pray for Kevin Keith and Stanley Keith and Kim Lom and Jasmine. Pray for Emma Key. Pray for Regenia Jemison and her upcoming birthday, 21. God bless you, girl. Pray for Dana Johnson and Gay and Otis Knighton and Royden Knighton and Kevin Knighton and Sherry Harper Knighton. We pray for Audrey and her family and her children. And Lord, we continue to pray for Lillian, and we just want to see her walk through these doors once again. We pray for Rhea and Dimitri. Pray for Clarine. Pray for Brother Vonsell Lewis and just becoming a leader in the church. Pray for Venus. Pray for Daniel Mills Sr. and happy birthday, Vicky. Pray for Daniel and Zion and Alex. Pray for Darlene, Davine, and Omega, your mom, Catherine, William and Marie, and Jalen and Jasmine. Pray for Desmond Morris and Marie Martin, Regina and Cleve. Pray for our sister Val Murphy, just moving so swift these days. Pray for Aubrey Oden. Pray for Mikey O'Shea, Lord, and just help that brother out. Mikey, lean on the Lord. Pray for Ashley and her travels. Pray for her family, Stephanie, Karen, and Joseph. Pray for Wendy. Pray for Virginia and Greg Peniston for just continuing to support and share prayers with Faith Lutheran Church. Pray for Ed Perez and just his due diligence and perseverance and his partner, Tom Gonzalez, as they work behind the scenes for Faith Lutheran Church. Pray for Bobby Rutherford, and Lord, we pray for Brian. And this little upcoming procedure, Brian, we're going to pray for you, brother, and you're going to be fine. Pray for Crystal and Akilah and that great duet they did last week. It was beautiful. Pray for Asia. Pray for Manny, and we pray for Lux. And Lord, you hear our prayers. We just patiently wait on you to deliver all that we ask for in your name. We pray for Vinshona and Marceau and Josh and Sonny. We pray for Billy Rhodes Sr., and once again, doctor said, no problems, liver is good. So God bless you, Billy, and your blessed nurse, Debbie. And Debbie, you're talking well, and you're breathing well, and God is good. We pray for Honey and just her journey. Lord, just continue to hold her tight. We pray for Nyla, pray for Linda and Gwen, and we pray for Mother Ethel Souls and Brother Haram and our beloved Sheila, just doing better, looking better, moving better every day. And pray for Miss Dion Smith. And once again, God does everything for the good. Good to see you, Dion. And your brother, pray for your brother Terry also. And pray for Larry and Zoe and Margaret, and pray for Effie Thompson, just being a pillar of strength for me, Lord. Thank you, Effie. Pray for Peter and Robert Terrell, and pray for Gloria and Taylor Turner as her nursing career takes off. And we pray for Nikki Vaden, who's undergoing a little more chemo, Lord, but she's doing well. We pray for Marie and Aaliyah and Sabrina. And Lord, we pray for Chris, Elijah, and Ethan, and William. And we pray for Miss Ruth. Miss Ruth came out to Bible study this week, and Miss Ruth looking chipper as ever. God bless you. Pray for your son, Theron. And Lord, we pray for the Wilsons, Tanya, Mike, Naya, Jabari, Damani, and their mother, Doris. Pray for Michael and Tamara. Pray for Zenon and Richardson. And Lord, we pray for those who are hospitalized. We pray for the doctors and the nurses and the caregivers, those who are shut in, those in convalescent care, those in assisted living facilities. Lord, have mercy upon them and lead them on the path to health according to your good will. And we pray and celebrate all who are having birthdays, those who are having anniversaries. And we pray for the shared ministries here on our campus. Psalms Dance, New Salvation, New Challenge, The Saving Station, Blessed, Anointed, and Highly Favored, Bizrat Eritrean Church. We pray for those who travel, that they arrive safely at their destinations, and just be aware on these streets out here. Pray for leaders, those who work to bring peace, justice, and health in this and every place. We pray for the Lutheran organizations, Lord, the Black Clergy Caucus, Pacific Southwest District, Lutheran Women in Mission, Lutheran Church Extension Fund, Lutheran Social Services, and here at our church, our Vision Executive Ministry team for just working on a volunteer basis. So I thank you. We pray for our government, our military, our law enforcement. We pray for the Englewood School District and City Hall. We pray for college, high school, middle school, and elementary school, preschoolers, daycare for children and adults. And Lord, there's so much violence, so much hatred, so many families grieving senseless crimes and acts of violence. Be with those who go through bereavement. We pray for families of police brutality and just police misconduct in general. We pray for those who abuse their power and their authority. We pray for families of natural disasters. And Lord, we pray for the pyromaniacs who start fires and destroy people's lives. They have to deal with you, Lord. So be with all this destruction of fire, famine, and flood. And be with our families and the discord and the disconnect and just lack of forgiveness amongst ourselves. We pray for family members, just forgive one another in the name of Jesus. That these and any other things you see that we need, grant to us for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy, we now have the opportunity to bless the Lord with our tithes and with our offerings. Thank you.
fill me with life anew, that I may love what thou dost love and do what thou wouldst do. Breathe on me breath of God until my heart is pure, until with thee I will one will to do and to endure.
Please rise. Consider the gift of your only Son. We're self-conscious of the meager gifts that we bring. Therefore, we pray for a stronger faith to give of ourselves and our possessions more generously to those in need and to support the resurrection ministry through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. We continue with the reading of the Word of God.
May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Old Testament reading is recorded in Isaiah chapter 50, verses 4 through 10. Isaiah urges a bold faith. The Lord God has given me the tongue of those who are taught, that I may know how to sustain with a word him who is weary. Morning by morning he awakens. He awakens my ear to hear as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I turned not backward. I gave my back to those who strike, and my cheeks to those who pull out the beard. I hid not my face from disgrace and spitting, but the Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who is my adversary? Let him come near to me. Behold, the Lord God helps me. Who will declare me guilty? Behold, all of them will wear out like a garment. The moth will eat them up. Who among you fears the Lord and obeys the voice of his servant? Let him who walks in darkness and has no light trust in the name of the Lord and rely on his God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Our psalm of the day. I love the Lord because he has heard my voice and my pleas for mercy, because he inclined his ear to me. Therefore, I will call on him as long as I live. The snares of death encompass me. The pangs of Sheol laid hold on me, and I suffered distress and anguish. Then I called on the Lord. O Lord, I pray, deliver my soul. Gracious is the Lord and righteous. Our God is merciful. The Lord preserves the simple. When I was brought low, he saved me. Return, O my soul, to your rest, for the Lord has dealt bountifully with you. For you have delivered my soul from death, my eyes from tears, my feet from stumbling. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. Amen. Music ministry.
May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The epistle is recorded in James chapter 3, verses 1 through 12. James warns against an uncontrolled tongue. Not many of you should become teachers, my brothers, for you know that we who teach will be judged with greater strictness. For we all stumble in many ways. And if anyone does not stumble in what he says, he is a perfect man, able also to bridle his whole body. If we put bits into the mouths of horses so that they obey us, we guide their whole bodies as well. Look at the ships also. Though they are so large and are driven by strong winds, they are guided by a very small rudder, wherever the will of the pilot directs. So also the tongue is a small member, yet it boasts of great things. How great a forest is set ablaze by such a small fire. And the tongue is a fire, a world of unrighteousness. The tongue is set among our members, staining the whole body, setting on fire the entire course of life, and set on fire by hell. For every kind of beast and bird, of reptile and sea creature, can be tamed and has been tamed by mankind. But no human being can tame the tongue. It is a restless evil, full of deadly poison. With it, we bless our Lord and Father. And with it, we curse people who are made in the likeness of God. And from the same mouth come blessing and cursing. My brothers, these things ought not to be so. Does a spring pour forth from the same opening both fresh and salt water? Can a fig tree, my brothers, bear olives, or a grapevine produce figs? Neither can a salt pond yield fresh water. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to St. Mark, the 9th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
And when they came to the disciples, they saw a great crowd around them and scribes arguing with them. And immediately all the crowd, when they saw him, were greatly amazed and ran to him and greeted him. And he asked them, "What are you arguing about with them?" And someone from the crowd answered him, "Teacher, I brought my son to you. For he has a spirit that makes him mute. And whenever it seizes him, it throws him down. He foams and grinds his teeth and he becomes rigid. So I asked your disciples to cast it out and they were not able." And he answered them, "O faithless generation, how long am I to be with you? How long am I to bear with you? Bring him to me." And they brought the boy to him. And when the spirit saw him, immediately it convulsed the boy, and he fell on the ground, and he rolled about, and he was foaming at the mouth. And Jesus asked his father, "How long has this been happening to him?" And he said, "From childhood. And it has often cast him into fire, into water to destroy him. But if you can do anything, have compassion on us and help us." And Jesus said to him, "If you can, all things are possible for one who believes." Immediately, the father of the child cried out and said, "I believe, help my unbelief." And when Jesus saw that a crowd came running together, he rebuked the unclean spirit, saying to it, "You mute and deaf spirit, I command you, come out of him and never enter him again." And after crying out and convulsing him terribly, it came out, and the boy was like a corpse. So most of them said, "He is dead." But Jesus took him by the hand and lifted him up, and he arose. And when he had entered the house, his disciples asked him privately, "Why could we not cast it out?" And he said to them, "This kind cannot be driven out by anything but prayer." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please join in our hymn of the day, "Come by here, my Lord." You may be seated.
Come.
Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and from our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. I believe. Help my unbelief. Our Savior is able. In that scripture reading, it's kind of funny when someone asks Jesus if he can. Like the disciples, there is much that we are unable to do. And sometimes God leaves us unable to do things in order that we turn from ourselves and turn back to him. Because Christ most certainly can deal with everything in this sin-filled world. Our Christ is able to do things that we are entirely unable to do. Verse 18, so I asked your disciples to cast it out, and they were not able. And Jesus replied, O faithless generation, bring him to me. The disciples were not up to the job. Many times we are not up to the job. This is a doubt that has plagued us many times throughout the trials and the struggles that we go through. Because it's the truth. Sometimes we just can't get it done. There are things that no matter how hard we try, that we simply cannot do. And sometimes we are not up to the task at hand. In our reading today, the disciples were not up to the job. They had tried to help this poor father and this helpless son, but they could not do it. And your heart has to go out to this dad. How awful it must have been to watch this poor child, this dear boy, convulsing on the ground, foaming at the mouth until he was rigid, as if he were dead. It's bad enough when our children are sick, that a spirit is throwing your kid about and around. How terrible it must have been. And we can hear the heartbreaking anguish in this man's voice as he appeals to Jesus. There is no doubt that the disciples were moved by the Father's request when he first came to them. And without a doubt, they tried and they tried again, but nothing happened. How hard it had to be for the disciples to face this Father and this crowd desperately looking to them for help, and they were not able to do it. It's not like they hadn't done it before. The gospel makes it clear that the disciples had cast out demons. They had healed the sick, and they did it with him and after him and after he ascended. But this time they were not able. And for us, this is sometimes the way that God works. And God works this way to teach us, to deepen us in our faith and our trust in him. That's the way it works. Sometimes we are able to help our children, and sometimes we are not able. When little Aunt Sabrina's I first born, our son was born, he had asthma. And he was lactose intolerant before we knew what lactose intolerant was. And we couldn't help him. We couldn't fix him. And we could see he was suffering. He was struggling to breathe. And when we'd feed him, he would throw up. And he was struggling that he got a hernia and his little belly button popped out. and we were in anguish, and we couldn't help him. We prayed to the Lord, and he gave us the best doctor in the world. And she had a child that had the same conditions as our son. And she told us what to do, and it worked. And I got tired of taking him to emergency for these asthma attacks. And I asked the doctor, can I have one of these asthma machines to take home? And she said, no one's ever asked for that before. And she put in a request, and they gave me one. And so we was able to treat him at home. And the Lord healed him. Amen. Y'all see him now. You would never think he was a skinny, undernourished little, he couldn't breathe. But faith in Jesus, Jesus is able to do all things. In our reading, as I studied it, and some of the commentary was about epilepsy. And they would say, is it epilepsy or is it a demon? And they was wondering why the exorcism didn't work. But our Lord makes it clear, even if it was epilepsy, there was an unclean spirit behind it. But we have a God who sent us a Savior, and our Savior is able to do all things. He cast out the demon, and he frees the boy from the power of that evil spirit. And this is one of those places in Scripture where it is made very clear to us that no matter the trouble, no matter what's going on in your life, whether it is sickness in the body or the mind, whether it is this destructive weather, these hurricanes, these tornadoes, drought, global pandemics, we can be certain that the devil and his crew are at the root of it. Because we were born into a sin-filled world. Just because we can explain things by science, biology, chemistry, does not mean there is not evil at work. This might frighten some of us, cause people to raise their eyebrows, but it not for us. It does not do that. We know there is a spiritual world. We know that Jesus is in control over all things, both good and bad. But we know whatever it is, whatever the circumstances, that our Savior is able. He's able to cure, to heal, to renew, to save our souls. And in our reading today, the problem was not a misdiagnosis on the disciples' part. Their problem was the same as the poor father's. When he stood before Jesus and he said, if you can do anything, their problem and the dad's problem was lack of faith. I believe. Help my unbelief. And as shocking as it may be to hear someone say, if you can, to Jesus, it is understandable given that his followers, his disciples, had just failed to help this man and this boy. But it was not the first time, and it would not be the last time, that the failure of Jesus' followers will reflect to the Lord. There's plenty going on in this world today. But we cannot let our inability be compared to the ability of Jesus Christ. If you can, Lord, we probably never said that out loud, but we thought about it. When we allow troubles and trials that we face, when we let them weigh us down, rob us of our peace, as if we do not have a Lord and a Savior who is able to do all things. The Lord's good purpose is allowing us to face troubling times when we are not able, knowing that He's able. He lets us struggle, so He strengthens and deepens our faith in Him, in the one who is able. The Lord reveals this to His disciples when He answers their questions about why they could not cast out this spirit. And He says, this kind cannot be driven out by anything but prayer. To be clear, Jesus is not telling the disciples they needed to add something else, make their efforts better. In fact, He's telling them and He's telling us, let our efforts go and complete and cast them on Him. Cast them on His strength. Because our Savior is able to do all things to those who believe. When the Lord showed them, and all this was that the fact that they were not able, but He is able. It is not our power, it's God's power in us. And so all this is about faith. As Jesus says to the boy's father, all things are possible for one who believes. Faith, believing, does not find power in itself. The power is always God's faith, the object of God, our resurrected Savior Jesus. The trust of our heart does not accomplish anything. It is Jesus in whom our heart trusts. It is not what we do, it is what God does for us. The Lord is not telling His disciples that if they commit their minds and hearts to something and pray a whole lot, it will happen. He is telling them to let it all go and leave it in His hands, in the truth and faith that He is able. Our Savior is able even when we are not able. The trouble is weak faith. The trouble is little faith. It is not that we do not trust Jesus. It is that we are not totally dependent on Jesus. It is complete trust in Jesus that gets us through. Jesus gets the job done, no matter the sin or the task or the challenge. All things are possible for the one who believes, because our Savior is able. As the Lord in mercy, He helps the Father, and He delivers this poor boy before our eyes in our gospel today. He is at work to deepen and strengthen us in the one true faith, that He is more able to deal with anything and everything that we face. He is at work to strengthen and grow our weak faith, that our lives go through so much, we begin to look away from Him. And He puts us in situations to bring us back to Him. He says, I'm able if you believe. Christ can do everything. We are not able to do all things. Christ furthers the work of His word by directing our eyes to the cross. It is on the cross where he won eternal victory over sin, death, and hell by His bitter suffering and His humiliating death. We looked at Him sweating in agony. He was trying and trying for you and for me. And on the cross He says, it is finished. It is all done. And it's all done for us. He is more than able to take care of all things for you and all things for me. We look upon him, his wounds in his hands, the wounds in his feet, the wounds in his side, the blood flowing out of him. It is with this sacrificial death that all our worries, all our fears, and all our cares are to be cast upon him. Do not let our inability be compared to God's ability. Our Lord, by faith in him, can do all things for us. When in doubt, turn to Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ can get the job done. Amen. May the peace of God, which surpasses all our human understanding, guard our hearts and guard our minds in Christ everlasting. Amen.
Thy favor, early let us do thy will. Blessed Lord and only Savior, with thy love our bosoms fill. Blessed Jesus, blessed Jesus, thou hast loved us.
Please rise. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord, who, having accomplished our salvation, now reigns over all things at your right hand. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying,
Holy.
Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth, for you've had mercy on those whom you created and sent your only begotten Son into our flesh to bear our sin and to be our Savior. Grant us now a lively faith as we receive him under bread and wine, and gather us with all the saints to join in the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which has no end. To you alone, our Father, be all glory, honor, and worship, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the new testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." As often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
O Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, in giving us your body and blood to eat and to drink, you lead us to remember and confess your holy cross and passion, your blessed death, your rest in the tomb, your resurrection from the dead, and your ascension into heaven, and your coming for the final judgment. So remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Seated. We continue with the sacrament of Holy Communion. Those who are able, come to the communion rail. All others, please remain in your seat, and the usher will bring your communion. Thank you. Please prepare your communion cups. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he's betrayed, he spoke to his disciples and he said, take and eat. Take and eat the body of Jesus shed for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. In the same way also, he said, do this often in remembrance of me. Take and drink the blood of Jesus shed for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. It is through this eating and drinking that you may be strengthened in your Christian faith and in your Christian life and in your Christian walk. Go into the world with peace and joy, with the full forgiveness of all of your sins. Depart in peace. Amen.
Let us drink wine together.
Thanks, Heavenly Father, for this gift of life and the strengthening of our faith. Help us each day to rely on all that your Son has done for us and promised for our future. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now forever.
Amen.
The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you. The Lord look upon you with favor, and the Lord will give you peace. Amen.
Amen.
Our closing hymn, I Love to Tell the Story.
Love to tell the story of God's amazing love.
Good one that time. Peace of the Lord be with you.